It may happen to you many times that you want to create a loop animation. You can do this easily in After Effects by using Expression. Hello everybody, what's up? This is Mehdi from DR Tutorial Studio, and today I want to show you how to create loop animation in After Effects. I have already made a short video about this, but today I want to explain completely about how to make loop animation in After Effects and then explain different modes to you. So, if you're ready, let's get started. As you can see, I have created a very simple motion here with a few shape layers. Now, I select a small orange circle. I want to convert it to loop animation. To do this, hold down Alt and click on a sub-brush icon next to the position parameter. This will bring up coding section. Now, I must type loop out expression. Finally, to complete the expression, I add a semicolon to end and press Enter. Now, you can see that the small orange circle moves as a loop. That means when it reaches the last keyframe, it starts moving again from the first keyframe. Now, you know how to convert a single layer animation to loop. But if you want to make a loop animation from composition, it has a little difference. I made a pre-compose from these three layers, and now I want to make a loop from these pre-compose. The first step is to adjust the duration of composition that I want to make it loop. To do this, enter the pre-composition and press Ctrl-K to open the composition setting window. Now enter 4 seconds in duration section to set work area. You need to adjust the composition time according to your keyframes and project. Now go back to main composition and right-click on pre-compose. Then select Enable Time Remapping from the Time menu. Now you see that for time remap parameter, 2 keyframes have been created in 0 seconds and 4 seconds. Now I have to apply loopout expression for these 2 keyframes. As you can see, I could create loop animation easily by using loopout expression, but do not rush, because there are still a few tips that I have to tell you. As you can see, I have reopened the previous project. I select the top layer, and I want to apply loopout expression on this layer. This time, I will use another method for this. I click on this icon and go to the property menu. And here, you can see loopout option. I choose it. As you can see, the appearance of expression has a little difference. The phrase type equal cycle has written here. This expression is exactly the same as previous simple expression. So the default loopout expression mode is the same as cycle mode. Now let me select another circle and apply same expression on this layer too. This time I delete the cycle phrase and type ping pong instead. It has really interesting movement. This time, I select the large circle in middle, and I want to show you another mode on this layer. But before that, let me create 2 keyframes for the scale. Then I convert those keyframes to Easy Ease. Now I need to apply loopout expression on the scale parameter, and now I type continue in parentheses. I think you can guess what will happen. Scale will increase continuously until the end of the timeline. But you can see that after the second keyframe, the size of circle does not change. What is the problem? If I select the second keyframe of the scale and go to the speed graph section, you will see that because I have converted the keyframes to Easy Ease, the speed in second keyframe is 0 and we have no movements. All I have to do is increase the speed at the second keyframe. To do this, I select these points and move it slightly upwards to increase the speed. Now you can see that after the second keyframe, the size of circle increases at the constant speed. So in continue mode, pay attention to speed. here, I have made a very interesting and smooth movement by position. I select the position keyframes of the first layer and apply loopout expression on them. This time, I type offset in parentheses. Let me do the same for the second layer. You can see the difference between two layers which expression is applied on and the other two layers. Now let me apply this expression on the other two layers to complete the movement. It's so amazing! As you can see, by expression we can create very interesting animation. In fact, by using expression we can create very high quality animation in a few times. Now that we have talked about loopouts, let me explain you looping in a heartbeat. Here, I have a few keyframes in 10 seconds to 12 seconds. But I have no keyframes before 10 seconds and after 12 seconds. Now let me apply looping expression on the layer to see what will happen. You can see that the circle moves from 0 second to 10 seconds before reaching the first keyframe. Now, let me apply looping expression on the other keyframes. If I expand the work area a little, you will see that after 12 seconds, I mean the last keyframe, we have no more movement. If we want to repeat this movement after the last keyframe, we have to use loopout expression. Now this is end of this tutorial and thanks for watching this video and I hope you enjoyed watching it and it will be useful for you. And if you have any question, you can ask me anytime. At the end, don't forget to like this video.